exploratory note of the morning, kind of first day back, really, well, really being on camera and actually filming the practice room. Been pretty busy. If you haven't already, go check out the first episode of the Pedal Studio that launched on Wednesday, and I was going through the dub Terrania by Iron Ether. I'll try and link that somewhere on the screen right now. If not, it's linked below in the description of this video. Also, don't forget the live masterclass on chordal harmony coming up on Tuesday. That's the 31st. Whatever the 31st is, I think it's Tuesday. Maybe it's Monday, but whatever it is, the 31st of March, wherever you are in the world, it'll be 9 a.m. here in California. And it's to kind of celebrate the fact that Chordal Harmony is our book of the month. That is linked below. It is 50% off both physical and digital copies. And I'll be giving a live 2-hour masterclass. We're going to be streaming live on YouTube and just taking your questions and talking about that book and working on the exercises in that book, kind of an in-depth, deep dive on chordal harmony for the bass. And kind of very apropos, I'm actually working on some chord things. I'm going to start calling this podcast the Stealing All Gabriel Santiago's Licks podcast, because that's basically what I'm doing. If you haven't checked out his new podcast, Speaking of Harmony, go give that a watch or a listen. Some great voice leading stuff. And he was talking a few days ago about introducing this kind of diminished sound over the one. I'm not going to give a detailed explanation of it right now, but I can tell you this is what it sounds like. And if you want to check it out, go check out his podcast. He's way better at explaining it than I am, but it's a really cool exercise on bass, finding a decent voicing, and then reharmonizing. Just reharmonizing that major scale. And then I was working on switching positions, getting up a little higher, and then going up here, more of a 5-string voicing. And then this one, a little more difficult to get to, and on the root. So you can do the whole scale. I'm by no means really close to nailing that yet. Where is it? So what I've been working on is kind of going up and down that. So out of my brain. Mm-hmm. Let's try again. Also, I've talked about this a little bit before, like that brittle feeling. Definitely feeling that right now with the instrument. Generally a sign of I'm like pushing too far ahead too quickly. I probably need... Probably need a more basic warm-up. Oh, now what the hell was what I was working on a little bit? Was the Bottesini double bass concerto number 2. Did not work on this enough, apparently. Phrasing it at all yet. This is like just basically getting the notes together. I gotta get that for it. So. Complicated as I'm perceiving it to be. No. High up. I don't know enough about the upright bass to know exactly what's going on there, whether that is a harmonic or whether there's just range up in, you know, super dusty end of the neck, but that's... That's the only way I can do it, is by playing false harmonics. So beautiful melodies. Classical bassists listening right now, you I hope you're quite close to a puke bucket, because you know how this is supposed to sound. I know how this is supposed to sound. It's also probably not supposed to be played on the electric bass, but it's, these are such beautiful melodies. I was listening to, the notes are this. So just one note there, one A, and then one recording I was listening to, the player repeated the A. Discipline, though, for me anyway, just on the reading front, really good to. And I'm not sure if it's just because of the register that it's written in the treble clef, on this little piano score and solo part. I don't know, but it makes sense that it's written in the treble clef. I wish more people would write kind of melodies and stuff up there. Exercises, yeah, it's good to be able to read ledger lines, I think, but long melodies like that to me sit way better in the treble clef for reading. Whoa, and I didn't shut off the phone. I thought I just did that. Okay. Let's try again. The whole front page here, just because I don't want to do the page turn, but let's try the front page. So I love this melody. Come on, page turn. To crescendo to forte there when you're playing false harmonics. Sforzando. Discipline, well, I like it. Melody's a good discipline anyway, regardless of like the technique that it takes to get you there. It's yeah, really. Brittle warming up a little bit now. Fingers are still actually cold, but technique feels like it's warming up a little bit at least. Maybe it's time for some simplicity. Developing here. Yeah, if I could play it right. Okay, let's try again. I spent too long on the A minor. That's another sign of like not really being in control or things not being warmed up, is like pressing too hard to get the result, I think, and pulling the string off the neck. At least that is for me. Let's see again. comping is kind of ugly. I should maybe just time on the G. I wanted to hang out the G line. That change. Well, not the change isn't clunky. I'm playing it clunky. What is that? Ooh, that is loud and old. If I play it double time. Thank you. Still gotta make. Not a bad little exercise. Yes, okay. In D flat, because I know I'm going to get questions. Hey, what was that tune at? Blah blah blah. The 30-minute mark or whatever, wherever we're at right now. That's Waltz in D flat from the Bass Duo album with John Davis. You can listen to that on Spotify, I believe. Maybe Bandcamp as well. A little bit of numbness in my right thumb. That means something is not right with my technique. Like I'm pressing too hard on the back of the neck for some reason. That's not good. Let's adjust my posture here. Maybe there's some tension somewhere. Thank you. definition underneath that. Kind of runs. Certain muscles, I guess, that we are not going to be able to exercise with this social distancing or quarantine or coronavirus situation. Most importantly, not going to be able to exercise the live performance and the immediate feedback from from the audience, which is kind of a bummer. And kind of being in that moment, like, it's weird. I'm thinking about it too much right now when I was just playing this idea. As I was playing that, stupidly, I guess, I was thinking to myself, wow, if there was an audience here, there would be no choice but to be more in the zone than I am, thinking less and like screwing up less, because you don't want to shortchange the audience with your performance. And you want to be in the moment. You want to play really honestly. And I think, at least for me, I get that when I'm in that pressure situation, I operate, I don't know whether there's like an auto function in my brain that just says, okay, now here it is, shut everything else off, and here we go with performance mode. Maybe that's something that splits practice and performance apart for me. Maybe that's for you as well. Let me know. Comments and questions. I should have said that way sooner in the podcast. YouTube, people of YouTube, comments and questions below the video, please. That, you know, even more important right now when we're all social distancing and not seeing each other for real in the flesh. The communication, keeping the lines of communication open is even more important, I think. And yeah, do that. Voice your opinion. Also, give me some feedback on what pedals you might want to see next. I have like hundreds behind me, as you can well see. And I'm known for a few things, I guess, like OC2 kind of stuff and a couple of delay things, some looping stuff. So I'm for sure going to do that at some point on the pedal studio on the show. But maybe there's something specific you want to hear about. Let me know. Like, give me some feedback below this video. Already been some great suggestions below the actual show itself. Having so much fun with all the cinematography and the soundtrack and the script and everything. It's really fun. It's like, I feel like I kind of have a TV show right now. I just hope I haven't overcooked it on the first episode and set the bar too high. Last thing I want to do is feel pressure to keep The last thing I want to do is feel pressure, period. So, right now it's just all super fun. And as long as the ideas keep coming in, I think it will just stay super fun. Some kind of thank you. Ending the podcast here, stealing more of Gabriel's lyrics. Go check out the Speaking of Harmony podcast, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and if you're enjoying what you see, hit the thumbs up, that helps. And don't forget, everything is linked below, everything I talked about, books and stuff, and our live masterclass, 2-hour chordal harmony masterclass, coming March 31st, 9 a.m. Pacific time, Los Angeles time, here in the morning. I'm going to get out of bed nice and early, warm up, and be ready for you. So please bring your questions. If you don't have a copy of Chordal Harmony already, it's linked below. It is 50% off the whole month of March 2020. It's our Book of the Month promotion, and you don't need the book to join in with the masterclass. It will just help if, you know, I'll be referencing exercises and pages and concepts in that book. So if you have it, it'll definitely help help with the class. Other than that, just trying to bring some value and something of use. If you are home, if you are not already, I guess, overloaded with Instagram live streams and Patreon things and you know, everything that's going on right now with social distancing and musicians being home and having way more time than they normally do. If you're not overloaded with that, please come and hang out with us. I think Chelsea's going to join us as well, and maybe do a little comment moderation, keep things running smoothly. And I'm sure she will be open to taking questions as well. So really looking forward to this. Haven't done a live thing like that with Chelsea ever, I don't think, in this capacity. And I don't think I've ever really done like a proper live masterclass with a specific topic of chords. All the stuff in chordal harmony. And if you want to ask me about some of these things of Gabriel's that I'm ripping off, then be my guest. We'll talk about all things chords. I will have the 4-string as well, so it's not just exclusively 5-string with high C, or 5-string or 6-string in general. It's going to be all inclusive. Yeah, so thank you guys, girls of the bass world, for spending some time with me today, and I'll see you on the next episode.